Hello everyone, and welcome to the Modern Java course. In this video, we'll delve into one of the most misunderstood and controversial changes to Java, modules. Before I proceed, as usual, the code for this and the other videos in this series is available on my GitHub page. So check this out, this project, start it, and follow me on GitHub. Modules were introduced into Java 9. This version trimmed some APIs that were added in Java 8, such as Jaxby, and removed some features specific to the Oracle JVM, such as JavaFX. A major motivation for these changes was the module system. Oracle wanted a cleaner slate to work with. But why do we need modules, and why do all that work? Packages might have interdependencies and internal implementation details that we might not want to expose when publishing an API. With modules, we can export only the applicable pieces. Furthermore, we can package only the applicable pieces that matter. The JDK itself is modularized, and you can define specific module dependencies. If you don't need the other modules, you can create a custom JVM without the unnecessary modules. This helps us think in boundaries and clearly define our dependencies. There are more than two benefits to using modules, but there are two big picture benefits. We can reduce our dependencies on external jars and even on the full JDK. If we don't use everything within Java, we can create a stripped down version of the JDK and shrink our application footprint. By having clean separation between modules, our application code can be more flexible. The flip side is the second benefit. We can expose only the parts we want. This gives us the flexibility to evolve our API freely. This is a map of the modules in the JDK and their dependencies. This looks like a mess and is indeed a bit of a mess. Notice that all roads lead to java.base. This is the base module in Java. This is the most basic core package in Java, and all other packages depend on it implicitly. Everything else is optional. Let's start with a simple Hello World application. We'll add a logger to this application to print the sophisticated information we have here. We then add usage of the logger to the UI, and we'll try to run this Hello World variant. As expected, this works reasonably well, and the application functions fine. Now let's try and break it with the module system. Let's create a new file called module-info.java. Notice that this isn't a valid Java class name due to the minus character in the name. This means that the file will never collide with existing Java files and doesn't use the standard Java syntax. We define the name of the module, which has a reasonable default for now. I can add a requires clause to indicate the modules I want. In this case, I will only include the base Java module. Now, when we go back to the code, you will notice that the code will no longer compile. Java can no longer find the logger, not even the package. This lets us limit our usage of the API to a specific subset. Notice that this is a 100% optional feature. Before I added the module, we effectively imported everything. This is a self-imposed restriction that we use to maintain discipline and cleaner code. Think of a module system like a small microservice that disconnects your jar dependencies from one another. Using this tool, we can isolate the various teams working on the project. By adding a dependency on the logging module, we can fix this problem. And now when we go back into the code, we can see that the logger is once again available. This time we know that only two modules are used in the project. This can speed up native compilation with GraalVM and let us package smaller versions of the JDK, but the advantages are much bigger. Let's create a new package. One is an API package in which we will place the public API for this module. This is the public facing code that we want people to use. The other is an internal implementation package. The code there isn't bad, but we will probably refactor it in the future. We wouldn't want users to import that code and start hacking. That will mean their code will break once we make a change. In the past, we had to do some serious hacks with package private classes. This worked, but made it very difficult to organize our packages the way we wanted them. This is the ideal situation where I can use the import package in my code, but a user won't be able to do that since we will only export the public API package. The implementation package will remain hidden and external jars won't have access to it. Modules are a relatively simple feature. Other module systems include far more elaborate capabilities. Still, they are very powerful and frameworks such as Spring are picking them up to improve isolation. If you're considering microservices for its logistic advantages, please think about modules first. They carry many of the advantages without the overhead. In the next video, we will discuss the micro benchmark suite. Follow through the videos to check out the full course. If you have any questions, please use the comment section. Thank you.